So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Devin Duvernay now returning from the end zone.
Can't believe I just did a pick six with a D tackle. That's like AJ getting a pick six in a fucking football game.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Remember, they were just out here a moment ago through the pick six, so we'll see if they can take better care of the football this go around.
Yeah, and sometimes, partner, I think it's almost better that you just throw the pick six and you come right back out on the field. You're not over on the sidelines drilling for it for very long. You're not hearing everyone say, "Hey, you'll get them next time. Hey, don't worry about it." All that stuff just goes right out.
Oh, I'm streaming, bud.
Right back out on the field with a chance to atone.
That's going deep for Bateman.
Oh, and
it's caught inside the 35. And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. Rashad Bateman. 83 yards.
Rashad the Bateman.
And the Ravens are able to strike
so
quickly
bad.
Here as they are in for six. Justin Tucker for the extra point. It's up and good. So these teams match touchdowns here in the first quarter, and we're tied 7-7. So all even at seven now as they kick it away. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone.
The Texans take over first and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
Let's go now. Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. They had the interception last drive, led to the tying touchdown. So 7-7 the score as they begin first and 10. Linebacker Patrick Queen bringing him down.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
Here's a second and five. Throwing now is Stroud. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. Stroud.
It's not a good pass.
So. And he'll get this underneath to Singletary. And he's brought down short by a yard. It's a third down gain of four.
Come on.
Singletary, they'll run for it. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. A big roll of the dice on fourth and one, but it pays off. They convert. First and 10, it's Stroud. That's to the veteran, it's Robert Woods. And he will be out of bounds here on what will turn out to be the final play of this first quarter. So in Raven territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 44-yard line. And Stroud now to throw. And that's going to be caught downfield by Brown.
Son of a bitch, man.
15-yard line. It was an impressive 31-yard gain. Back to the ground with Pierce.
Ooh.
And here he'll get it down to the 7. From the 7, it's 2nd and 5. Now Stroud. Swings this one out wide for Pierce. Touchdown, Texans!
I gotta pee real quick. That nigga looks like he's off a perk. Fuck.
No, he missed the PAT. No good on the extra point, so a letdown there, and this will stay a 6-point ball game. Now he's back out there to boom this
one away,
maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. Duvernay now going to bring it out.
You're home.
And he'll get it up across the 20 to the 21-yard line. The Baltimore offense at the line set to get going. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that. Charles' defense, they were very frustrated after giving up 6 the last time on the field.
And Friday was just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated, they both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other. I really like the vision he displayed on that play, because he saw there wasn't a lane to completely break off a huge gain, so he found where there was the most space and got what he could. A nice dirty run that's a positive play for the offense.
No way.
And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. And chalk that one up as a gain of 34 on third down.
When teams practice their plays during the week, they're hoping that it's going to pay off on game day. So it sure has to feel good for them when they hit them during a game and they hit that one there for big yardage.
And to the 36-yard line, taken down there after getting 8 yards.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely, pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
On second down, it's Edwards. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. 2 yards, good enough for a first. And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. They go play action with Jackson. His throw incomplete.
Well, a momentary speed bump there with that throw, partner. The defense had other ideas, and they tried to mount a small stand before this drive reaches the end zone.
You have to show up the
court. Now Jackson on second down. Under pressure, and the Texans able to get in there for the save.
What?
That was Will Anderson getting home and finishing the play.
Like over here, like the cop, I don't think the cop has to show up to court. Like, when I got my speeding ticket, the cop didn't show up to court.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And it's knocked away.
I went to court. It got pushed down to a parking ticket. Not like when I was talking to the cop, because I never got a ticket before, so I was talking to the cop, and he was pretty chill and shit like that. And he was like, yeah, you're just going to go to, like, the Riverhead. He was like, honestly, he's like, if you go to the court, they'll end up most likely taking it down to a parking ticket or something like that if I don't show, and I probably won't show. So
ready to go here for their next drive. Still more than a minute to go.
90 and a 55, or 71 and a 55.
Not only time, but they have 3 timeouts at their disposal as well. So that changes everything that you're doing here.
It was like a 72 and like a 55.
The field's still available because you can call timeout and regroup. On second down, here's Pierce. And he'll go out of bounds just shy of the 20.
So I got a parking ticket and like 10 hours of fucking cleaning service.
And that requires some confidence some fortitude and a little bit of hope, doesn't it? You hope you catch the defense just right and break off a big run to help yourself out.
Yes.
This past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. Good coverage downfield led to him taking off, picking up the first down on a 13-yard run. Stroud looking to throw. Man open, that's complete to Dalton Schultz. The Texans will burn the first of their timeouts.
The cop doesn't have to show up. More than likely, the cop doesn't show up to fucking traffic court.
So after two first downs, they get another here. First and 10 at the 45. Stroud to throw it. That's complete. It's Collins. That'll go for a gain of 7. And it's second down. Now the Texans will use one of their two remaining timeouts. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. On second down, it's Stroud. This is caught. It's Woods. And he's going to be taken down with the first down.
Oh, sure. I have three people watching right now.
The Texans going to signal for their third and final timeout. And with halftime on the horizon,
chat is getting crazy out here. We got three viewers in here. Shit getting crazy.
Again, it's Stroud.
No, I hit the wrong button.
And
fuck.
This one may draw a penalty. He just blindly threw that one to the sideline. And
yep,
indeed, the flag is out.
What the fuck, the wrong button?
They lose the yardage, and of course, they also lose the down on the grounding call, and it's quickly second and long. Back to throw. Here's Stroud. Flushed out right. Catches made. It's Schultz on the out route. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out.
Chat's so fucking blowing up right now, man. Again, subs gifted to me. Shit.
To see about getting 3 points. And his kick is good. And that will do it for this first half. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break.
NRG Stadium.
Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number 3. The Ravens set to receive the football, trailing here as we resume action
need a Zin.
In the third quarter.
Need a Zinster.
Duvernay now gonna bring
Zimbabwe.
It out. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid and he's
dropped
up
to the 18. Anybody in chat right now packing up a decky?
Got a couple of upper deckers in the chat. Yardage, but that hasn't translated so far on the
show. Yep, dickhead.
That's being Texans are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. But D'Amico Ryans, even with the defensive mindset, he'll elect to go for two here. And this one incomplete. So they went for the two. They don't get it. Tough there. Good pass. Hit the hands. He just couldn't bring it in.
And every receiver's coach everywhere seeing that play, focus, focus, focus. Watch it all the way in and tuck it away.
And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. So now, Charles, this drive, maybe a touch more important, trying to erase the memory of that interception they had the last time out.
Yeah, and everyone goes through this because even the best in the game, you're going to have games where it just doesn't go right for you and interceptions result. So, frankly, to me, it's all about how you respond, not just the types of plays that you call, but how you carry yourself
how you show your team that you're still with it, and how you continue to lead.
And give him about five as he gets this up to the 48-yard line.
Not a huge play, but I think they're more than happy with how it turned out. Don't be surprised to see them revisit that call, because there was a lane there for more than just 5 yards. Put it in your back pocket and break it out when you need it later.
On second down, here's the option. And they nearly sprung him that time as he takes this all the way down to the 37. Really good effort. He does it himself, picks up 15, also picks up the first down.
Well, partner, for a few years there, we thought this read option play was going to take over the whole NFL. It seemed like everyone was using it, but it has been scaled back considerably in the last few seasons, mainly because people worried about their quarterbacks.
Oh, and for the third time, Jackson going to be intercepted. Oh, they try a lot.
No, I tried to help.
So they escape, so to speak, maintaining the football. Defensively, though, opportunity missed.
It definitely was, because that's all defenses talk about, getting the football and either advancing it the other way or just getting possession and turning it over to their offense. That can be a little bit deflating. You're exactly right, a lost opportunity.
From the red zone now, here's Jackson on first down. Got a man, it's caught for a Ravens touchdown. Gus Edwards from 17 yards out, and the Ravens are back within a score. And this is no good. It's a missed extra point. Boy, in a tight game, how important might that turn out to be here as the second half rolls along? So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. And no thought to bring this one out. He'll just go down to a knee, and they'll take over at the 25. Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter when the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go around. The extra effort after the catch makes it good for a gain of 26 and also a first down. Here's Stroud. Escaping the pressure right.
Go get the ball, you fucking inbred fucking.
Picked off by Rakia Sin. And he will bring this back. It's a pick six and a Raven touchdown.
I'm playing with the retard, I guess.
Well, they matched their opponent's pick six from earlier. Those are some crucial points that may prove pretty consequential as to how this one plays out.
And Brandon, I think now we're not just watching how they move around the field, but we're checking their psychology out. Because that defense, they're about to go right back out with all the momentum on their side. As for the opposing offense, you wonder if there's going to be some hesitation to lean entirely on the passing game to try and mount a counterattack.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. This will be returned from deep in the end zone. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. And not the first time that they're coming back out off of a turnover, but the last one really hurt Charles with that pick six.
And it feels like the whole team's infected right now, doesn't it? It's not just been one person. It's kind of been a group effort with the mistakes that happened. Can they put that aside, kind of start over, and put together a nice drive? You know what I like about that play? He didn't try to do too much on first down. He took what the defense gave him, put together a solid gain to bring up second and manageable. Now they have a couple of plays to pick up just a few yards and a new set of downs.
A quick throw here out to Brown. So just 3 yards on the completion there. And that's going to make it third down and less than a yard.
I'm playing dumb right now.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
And this will be a Texans first down as he's got this past the 35 to about the 37. Stroud to the air on first and 10.
eluding the pressure right. Throw the ball. You know, when I did that fucking, when I pitched it back, there was literally a guy right behind me, and just wasn't doing it. Maybe a little bit gun
shy throwing it around. Yeah, underthrowing him there, and you're right. Those interceptions may be in the back of his mind. And they run the option on second down. And this winds up a pickup of two, maybe two and a half to about the 39. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. Stroud on third down now. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. And you know, it's the same to attack right now. That's easy because he was wide open. And once he made the catch, plenty of room to work his way downfield. Back now in Houston. And we've got a Danny here. 1-point game as we begin the fourth. Question now, how do they want to work the clock here on first and goal? A field goal would give them the late lead. They'll run here with Pierce. And running room hard to come by here. He gets it down to the 8. He'll get 2 out of that run, and it's going to bring up a second and goal.
The yards may start getting a little tougher to come by down here near the goal line. That's good work defensively there on first down, holding them to a short gain.
Second and goal, operating from the 8-yard line. Operating from
the
end zone, but it's incomplete.
That one was thrown into the end zone, and when they made a play on the ball, it was actually tipped up in the air. And that's not ideal for anyone on defense, because what you're ordinarily taught is to knock the ball down towards the ground, almost like a volleyball player coming over the top and spiking it, to make sure that the offensive guys can't catch it on the rebound.
A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, third and goal. Quick throw by Stroud, complete.
Get in there.
And he is out of bounds here. That pass play good for 7, but it still brings up a fourth and goal. He got out of bounds, that's a good thing, but still short of the first.
And now, since this brings up fourth down, the defensive play caller, grab your nerves, because now you don't want to be so amped up that you give them a first down by getting out of your lanes, but you also don't want to just lay back and let them have it easily.
Now the Texans will use one of their 2 remaining timeouts. That's going to leave them with just 1 remaining here in this fourth quarter.
It's about time, fellas.
Likely the play of the game here, trailing in the final quarter and going for it on fourth and goal. Stroud keeps it, and he gets into the end zone. Touchdown, Houston. The sneak successful from a yard out.
T-R-A-R.
The Texans put together a fourth quarter drive to take the lead. Here we go now as we get set for a big 2-point conversion. They're going to keep it on the ground.
Let's fucking go.
And he will get into the end zone for the 2 points, and that helps. That gives him a 7-point lead. The Texans kick team as they'll send this one away. Duvernay now going to bring it out. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. They now trail by 7 after that last touchdown here in the fourth quarter. What a big spot for this offense. See if they can cobble something together on this drive. But now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. He did an okay job of absorbing the hit, just couldn't secure the football through the catch.
And he was right there on the spot and forced the incompletion. That's something defenders work on all the time. If you're there, make the contact, but continue to work your way through the receiver until he can't possess the football and turn it into a catch.
Possibly a turning point. Big play. This is third and long. Jackson. That is incomplete.
Some coaches have to take the shorter, more reliable yardage, and some, they have to go for the big shot. No fear lifting a deep ball there, but it wasn't enough to get him the completion.
The Ravens send their punter out now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. Taken in at the 22. That's going to go in the books as a 55-yard punt. Well done.
And the Texans will take over.
Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. Right now clinging to a one-score lead, Charles, and I think operating within that four-minute offense with a little less than 4 minutes to go applies here, right?
It certainly does, and that means the playbook is still wide open. But you are a little bit more careful about what you're calling. You want plays, they're going to gain yardage, how would you say it, consistently, right? You don't need the big shots downfield, but make sure the clock continues to run. Pile up the first downs, and the goal? End the game with your quarterback kneeling down at the end, and you still have the lead.
And Woods will go in motion right. They'll fake the jet sweep, and now Stroud to throw off play action. And he'll be upended at the 33 following a gain of three. And guess what? It brings up third down.
The plan was clearly to challenge them by sending a blitz on second down, but even the extra guys couldn't catch him in the backfield, though. He doesn't scramble for a first, but he does get the last laugh by evading the blitz and getting beyond the line of scrimmage.
And to find the open man, that's complete. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. So it's Texans football as we welcome you back. They've got a first and 10 as they look to try and finish this one off. Play action. Stroud down. They'll get the hook up there to Woods. And he gets this one inside the 15. Just a yard or two shy of the 10.
I just love how they're going about trying to finish off this game. This is not an offense that's going to go into its shell. They're going to keep exploiting weaknesses where they see them. And that's a huge pickup there with the game in the balance.
And this is caught. And that could seal it. It's a touchdown.
That is game.
Well, to put it mildly, he's been able to dice up the secondary all game long. And this time, that was a missile. Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw.
Oh,
that'll be incomplete.
Let me go ahead and show my age a little bit. It when they would fake it from the 3 yard line, right? When you'd line up, go ahead, and oh, there's a
fake. That little
fake. He's gonna get two, that's great. But from the 15, the risk reward is just not
fucking great.
You see the result right there.
Yeah, I know these young whippersnappers are trying to do different things in this game, but let's go back to reliable. Kick the ball through the post.
Get off my lawn.
That's darn right.
The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. These guys definitely hoping for a better showing than their last appearance. They couldn't really even move the football.
My brother is ass. Fucking man.
We'll see if they can get a better, more sustained drive going here.
Yeah, and every team that we ever talk to says the exact same thing. When you start a drive from that deep in your own territory, the goal is a minimum of at least two first downs. Because even if you have to punt then, you change the field position, right? You flip the field a little bit. They didn't get that done. This time they've all strung together a nice drive and help themselves out.
Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with 65 seconds remaining. Now Jackson. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Limited time left on the clock after that incompletion, so I think both sides are going to savor every second to prepare before the next snap. Because once the ball's in motion, it may be a non-stop push to finish this drive off. Everyone better be on the same page right now, because I think they're going to try and get several plays off in quick succession if they can.
Here's Jackson.
it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Back-to-back incompletions, but we know this is definitely four down territory. Time not on their side. I don't think they want to try and get the first down in two installments. I think they got to go and get it right here, right now.
Throwing, Jackson. And this is intercepted. And, oh, they try lateral on the return, and now the ball's loose. And the Texans scoop it. The ball comes out.
Well, I'm guessing that on the sidelines there might be a few words said about that mistake there, but I don't think it's going to hurt them in the long run. They're still going to get out of here with a win.
Yeah, they got the two-score cushion, but you know what coaches say, Charles? Finish strong.
Finish the game out the way it's supposed to be played. In fact, coaches might be secretly happy because of a chance to do a little extra coaching next week.
There they are, able to stop it, but he does take it all the way to the two.
Defensively here, you've got the cushion, but back-to-back pretty big pass plays there. Bend but don't break, but are they bending too much?
I think that they are. To me, it'd be like playing basketball, and you put up a token press. Make sure you get up there and make them eat up some time. Make it a little bit of resistance so they can't just run it right down your throat.
And this is going to be caught. So an offensive final score, not the outcome, but it is a late touchdown here on the game's final play. Won't be enough, but here's a final chance at the extra point. That one is good, but the final margin will be six as this one is over. Getting the touchdown there on the last play, but still,